the MGM Grand. Brian Custer, the host of Showtime Championship Boxing. Of course, yesterday we had the official press conference for Canelo versus Caleb Plant. Today, it is the official undercard press conference in what should be a historic night on November 6th, which is Saturday in just 2 days, when we will crown the first undisputed super middleweight champion of the world, the first in the sport of boxing. This fight card also has three fantastic fights here on the undercard, featuring former champions, top contenders, looking to make their mark on what should be a historic night. Of course, the Showtime pay-per-view undercard begins at 9 p.m. Eastern. That is 6 o'clock Pacific time here in Vegas. This event is being promoted by Canelo Promotions and one of the best in the business, TGB Promotions as well. Sponsored by Hennessy and Value. Three fights, former champions, top contenders on this undercard. Gonna talk to some of the fighters, also gonna take some of the questions here from members of the media. Let's start with the first fight of the night that opens the broadcast, 9 p.m. Eastern, that is 6 o'clock Pacific time. You've got an unbeaten fighter, Juan Pablo Romero, 14-0. 9 of his victories have come by knockout, and he will be taking on Elvis Rodriguez, 11-1-1, with 10 knockouts. Gentlemen, if you would, let's start by just giving an opening statement to let people know how things are going. Juan Pablo Romero, we'll start with you. If you could, just give the members of the media an opening statement and what we should expect come Saturday night.
Bueno, Juan Pablo, empezamos con vos en esta conferencia de prensa. Contanos tus expectativas iniciales y lo que podemos esperar de esta pelea.
Bueno, primeramente, muchas gracias por el recibimiento. Me enorgullece mucho estar aquí peleando en estos grandes escenarios que Canelo ha abierto a todos los pugilistas que queremos llegar a ganar un campeonato mundial. Venimos bien preparados, hemos estado en una carrera muy difícil como es el boxeo, pero 100% mexicana, donde nos enorgullece. Nosotros los mexicanos crecimos con dos deportes nada más, que es el boxeo y el fútbol, y bendito Dios, yo me gustó el boxeo y aquí estamos listos para la pelea. Venimos muy bien preparados y esperen de nosotros el día sábado un gran espectáculo, un gran combate, y con el favor de Dios vamos a salir con la mano en alto. Muchísimas gracias a todos los medios de comunicación por este recibimiento, y sin duda el sábado todos los mexicanos vamos a ganar, porque también celebramos apenas un día muy conmemorativo en México como fue el Día de Muertos, y a darle. Muchísimas gracias.
Well, thank you very much to all the media and the fans for receiving all of us so kindly here at the MGM Grand Arena. And you know, this is going to be a special weekend for all Mexicans. It's the Day of the Dead that we're going to be celebrating this weekend, and this is a fight that Canelo really opened the doors for us, and I really appreciate the fact that I'm going to be able to be a part of this undercard with such great fighters. And it has like 100% a stamp of the Mexican style of boxing. So I hope that I'm going to be able to provide a great show for the fans, and that in the end, I'm going to be able to win.
Elvis, same thing to you. If you would, give members of the media an opening statement. Let them know what we should expect on Saturday night.
Elvis, tus conclusiones iniciales.
Buenas tardes. Bueno, primero que nada, me siento bien contento, bien motivado de estar aquí en este gran evento. Y ha sido un camino bien largo para nosotros poder estar aquí hoy. Pero hemos trabajado bien fuerte, hemos trabajado bastante duro, hemos corregido muchísimos errores. Y creo que estamos mucho más listos para este sábado salir con la mano en alto.
Well, it's been a long road to get here, and I really appreciate the fact that I made it here. We had to work so hard, fix a lot of mistakes that made us better in the end. And now I'm confident that I'm going to be able to give my best on Saturday night.
Juan Pablo, here's the great thing about this opening fight. You guys get to set the tone for what we're going to see, not only throughout the night, but for the main event, what's the tone you're trying to set then Saturday night?
Sorry, could you repeat, please?
The great thing is, the opening fight gets to set the tone for what we're going to see, not only in the main event, but for the rest of the night. What's the tone he's trying to set Saturday night?
Bueno, ¿cuál es la pauta que vos querés determinar en esta pelea? ¿Qué es lo que querés que pase desde el principio en esta pelea contra Elvis?
Bueno, estamos prevenidos bien preparados para dominar el combate, demostrar el valor mexicano, el estilo mexicano de todos los boxeadores que traemos, de esa garra de ir adelante por nuestros objetivos, por nuestras metas, y meter la mano fuerte para... Tenemos la preparación suficiente para llevarnos esta victoria.
My goal here is to prove that the Mexican style of boxing is very much alive and well. I'm gonna go out there, be aggressive, and come out with the win, no matter what.
Elvis?
Bueno.
He said he's coming out for the win, no matter what. But you also told the media, on Saturday, I'm going to show Juan Pablo and the boxing public that I'm the real deal. What do you mean by that?
Bueno, Elvis, le dijiste a la prensa antes de esta conferencia que le vas a demostrar a todos que Elvis es la verdad, que es lo verdadero, y que le vas a demostrar a todos lo que sos capaz. ¿Qué quisiste decir con eso?
Bueno, claro que sí. Para eso venimos preparados, para demostrar al mundo del boxeo de qué nosotros estamos hechos. Como te dije la vez anterior que hablé, hemos estado trabajando encima de todos nuestros errores y esta vez venimos bastante fuertes, bastante preparados.
Well, my goal is to show everybody that I am the real deal. And like I said before, we have corrected a lot of mistakes. I'm a different fighter, a different person than I was in the past. And I'm ready to show everybody that I'm up to the challenge and that I can prevail in the end.
Last question. Juan Pablo, you're facing the man who came on the scene and he knocked out 10 of his first 11 opponents. He says he's looking to bring the fight to you. What are you looking to bring to him?
Bueno, Elvis ha noqueado a 10 de sus primeros 11 oponentes. Él también es agresivo. ¿Qué vas a hacer vos contra él para contrarrestar ese tipo de agresividad?
Pues bueno, mira, nosotros también somos boxeadores que vamos hacia adelante, vamos metiendo la mano fuerte, entonces no nos preocupa que él haya noqueado a 10 o a 20. Nosotros sabemos nuestra preparación, sabemos nuestras fortalezas, y con esa seguridad y con ese objetivo vamos a salir el día sábado.
We don't care if
he knocked out 10, 20, 30. We really don't care because we're aggressive as well. We're going to come out with our own game plan, with our own confidence, and securing the fact that if we do what we plan to do, we're going to be okay in the end.
Lastly, Elvis, what does a win over Romero do for you?
Bueno, Elvis, si le llegas a ganar a Romero, ¿qué crees que va a significar eso para tu carrera?
Bueno, creo que este va a ser el inicio, un nuevo inicio para mi carrera. Y creo que después de esto ya vienen cosas más grandes para él. Y nosotros hemos trabajado bien duro para llegar hasta aquí. Y creo que vamos a aprovechar eso al máximo. Estamos listos para este momento.
Well, if I beat Romero, I believe it's going to be a new beginning for my career. We have worked really hard to get here, but we want more. And I believe that's possible. And I'm going to try my best to show you guys how far I've come and how much I've improved.
Fantastic, thank you. That's the first fight of the night. We get to the second fight. And this should be a good one. Just like the first one. You've got Ray Vargas, 34-0, 22 knockouts, former WBC super bantamweight champion of the world, taking on Leonardo Baez. 21-4, 12 knockouts. And he has won his last three fights, by the way, by stoppage. Leonardo, we'll start with you. Give members of the media an opening statement, and what should they expect Saturday night when you take on Ray Vargas?
Bueno, Leo, conclusiones iniciales de lo que podemos esperar de vos en esta pelea.
Bueno, no, primero que nada, muchas gracias, ¿no? Muchas gracias a la promotora por la oportunidad, muchas gracias al gran campeón por darme la oportunidad también de pelear con él. Y pues, ¿qué puedo decir? No, nos preparamos muy, muy fuerte para esta pelea. No cualquier peleador se es el respaldo de esta cartelera de ahorita de Canelo Álvarez, que ahorita es el que más vende boletos, ¿no? Todos sabemos eso y pues tenemos esa oportunidad y realmente pues me preparé para no defraudar. Yo sé que voy contra un gran campeón, pero nos preparamos para eso.
Well, first of all, thank you very much to the promotion and to a great champion for allowing me to be a part of such a prestigious undercard. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to prove I'm ready to not disappoint anybody. Canelo Alvarez is the biggest draw in boxing, and it's truly an honor to be a part of something as big as this. So in the end, I'm going to try and do my best to come out with the win and not disappoint the fans that are going to be watching on TV and in the stands.
Ray, same thing. Give members of the media an opening statement. What should they expect? It's been basically 2 years since we last seen you fight.
Ray, no te vemos pelear hace 2 años. La gente está ansiosa por verte pelear. Contanos tus conclusiones iniciales sobre lo que podría ser una gran vuelta.
Sí, gracias por empezar. Y muchas gracias a toda esta gente bonita de Las Vegas, ese gran escenario. Y compartir cartelera con otro mexicano, Canelo Álvarez, es un gran orgullo y una gran alegría estar aquí.
It's a great source of pride and I'm really happy to be here. And first of all, thank you so much to Canelo Alvarez and everybody who made it possible to be here. And I'm really eager to show everybody what I can do after 2 years away. And I'm ready.
Hemos estado un tiempo fuera de ring por cuestiones obligatorias de alguna manera. Pero eso no quiere decir que estamos fuera de línea, al contrario, vamos a ver a un Rey Vargas nuevo, un Rey Vargas más adaptado y yo creo que con esa nueva faceta de disfrutar lo que haga arriba del ring. Venimos a hacer esas nuevas peleas que siempre hemos hecho, disfrutar, hacer ver el boxeo fácil de alguna manera y bueno, que la gente se lleve ese buen sabor de boca de un boxeo técnico.
Well, if you think that I'm rusty after 2 years away from boxing, you could not be more wrong. I came here to show that I can still bring the fight to them and to be able to show that Ray Vargas is still very much a contender and someone that's intact in his fighting skills. So we'll see what happens on Saturday, but I'm confident in my skills.
Leonardo, he said if you're thinking that he's rusty, forget about it. He's coming to bring the fight to you. You've won your last 3 fights by stoppage. Can you stop Ray Vargas Saturday night?
Bueno, vos ganaste tus últimas 3 peleas deteniendo a tus oponentes. ¿Crees que se viene la cuarta o crees que va a ser diferente?
Pues si se da la oportunidad, obviamente la vamos a agarrar, no la vamos a soltar, pero nosotros nos preparamos para los 10 rounds, ¿no? Porque nosotros sabemos el boxeo que tiene. Y pues como le digo desde el principio, nosotros nos preparamos muy bien para este gran compromiso y pues si se da la oportunidad, claro que la vamos a agarrar, ¿no? Si lo llegamos a aprender un buen golpe, no lo vamos a soltar, pero igual venimos preparados para los 10 rounds.
Well, look, if the knockout presents itself, the opportunity of knocking him out presents itself, then great. I'm not gonna shy away from one big punch. But we have had a great preparation and we prepared to go all 10 rounds if needed because we know that Ray Vargas is a quality fighter and we know the quality of the opponent that we have in front of us.
Ray, we'll wrap it up with this. Listen, we know you've been a champion, 122, but at 126, do you see Ray Vargas being a champion again at that weight? And I know in the past there was talk of maybe you and Gary Russell Jr. fighting. Do you see that as a fight in your future still?
Bueno, te ves con objetivos de campeón en un futuro cercano y además se habló en algún momento de que ibas a pelear contra Gary Russell Jr. ¿Te gustaría que eso suceda? Primero respondé la primera, traduzco y después me hablas de Gary Russell y traduzco eso. ¿Dale?
Ok. Por supuesto, sobre Gary Russell, estamos en la línea. Y estamos en negociación de esa pelea y bueno, para ser nuevos campeones de peso pluma, pero primero nos enfocamos en esta nueva pelea.
Well, as far as Gary Russell goes, if that fight happens, then we will be willing to take it and try to go after that featherweight title. But first of all, we're focused on Saturday. Nothing else crosses our mind but that. Second question. and you know, a really all-out brawl, and that's what I can promise you.
Fantastic. Now we get to the co-main fight of the night. You've got one man looking to make his mark, show the boxing public that not only is he a world-class fighter, but wants to show that he's a serious contender. You got the other man, former two-time world champion, looking to claim another title. Marcos Hernandez, 15-4, in two, three knockouts, out of Fresno, taking on the dog, Anthony Durrell. 33-2-2, 24 knockouts, two-time world champion at 168 pounds. It's the co-main fight of the night. Marcos, let you address the media, give them an open statement, let them know how things have been going and what they should expect come Saturday night.
Hello, thank you for the opportunity and looking forward to making it more opportunities.
Anthony, same thing, address the media. What should we expect when the dog is back in the ring come Saturday night?
First of all, I want to thank Showtime, Al Heyman, Marco for taking the fight. Expect fireworks. I know Marco brings a good game, and he's a come for a fighter. So, co-main event, you know, is going to be a hot one. I'm coming in there trying to make my mark and trying to get me a title shot at the winner of the main event. So, I gotta make a good statement with that. So, I know Marco will bring it. I know it's not going to be an easy fight, and I'm ready for the challenge.
Marcos, you've certainly spent the majority of your career, a lot of your career, at 160. Now you're stepping up to 168. Talk to me about stepping up to 168. You're fighting a two-time world champion. Will it be too much come Saturday night?
This is a fight I've never said no to nothing. If the fight gets to me, I'm gonna say yes. So I was just grateful for the opportunity to get a fight at a two-time world champion. And my last fight was at a 65, 60 before that, 68 before that, or whatever that was. I've been all over the place weight-wise. I don't really care. I just want to fight.
What would a victory over Anthony Durrell say about Marco Hernandez as a fighter into the boxing public?
Well, that's for everybody else to decide. I'm just looking forward to victory and the opportunities that will come with that. As far as opinions, I don't know. I don't have an opinion.
Dog? 0-1-1 in your last two fights. How imperative is it for you to get back in the win column?
This is a big opportunity under one of the biggest fights this year, especially the super middleweight undisputed. Like you said, never been an undisputed champion. So this is a big card. I'm just trying to make my mark. I'm trying to get a win under my column and get back to where I was. I think I should have won my last fight, but that's water under the bridge. We'll go for it from there. Once I get this victory on Saturday, we'll see where the win takes me.
And it begs the question, is Anthony Durrell still one of the elite top fighters at 168 pounds?
I think I am. I think I'm still up there. I think, you know, a few people still consider me, you know, up there. But it all depends on what I think of myself at the end of the day. I bring a lot to the table. They know that I don't shy from anyone. I don't back down from anyone. I'm just going to step to you like I'm supposed to be there. So come Saturday, you'll see what this camp did to me.
And lastly, you talked about facing the winner, obviously, of Canelo and Caleb. Is that a thing where you say, hey, look, Saturday, I want to come out, I want to look spectacular, so that they say, well, hey, that guy should be next, whomever is the winner of that main event?
Definitely, definitely. I want to, like I said, I want to make a mark. Don't put a doubt in people's mind about, you know, who should have next and who shouldn't. I'm 37 years old. You know, I'm at the age where, you know, a lot of people consider retirement. So I'm ready. I'm ready for this opportunity. I go into camp 100%. I give everything 100% that I have, and you'll see it on Saturday.
And the reason why I ask that is because, you know, a number of people and guys have written, like Benavidez or maybe Charlo coming up, should fight the winner of that one.
I mean, they have a good, you know, chance to. But you know, from me being here, me being a veteran in the game, at 37 years old, I think I'm, you know, well equipped to, you know, handle the winner.
I know there's a number of members of the media who have questions, so I want to allow you to ask them. Let's start with Keith Heidick from the boxing scene.